going to one and a half present here. Now we are, I'm Dr. Pagapriya from CIC department. I'm going to take with the human computer interaction. In that I'm going to take the design process, how we are doing it, and in the real time how we are able to interact the human, that is, you are going to interact the machine and the man, and how we are going to do it out. So now, first we have to know that what is meant by human interaction. So when you say it as human interaction, it's nothing but how a man and the machine is going to interact. It can be a machine. So when you take it as a computer, it's only a machine you have it, and how you're going to interact a man and the machine. It can be a way of how presentable way, how interactive way they're going to do it. You can have many devices to do it out. Why it is important is nothing but everything is being done only with the computer. So even it is not, before it was only with the aristocrats and the intelligent people were doing it. Now everyone is going on with the computers only. Each and every, even the layman is asked to know how to use the thing. So when you are doing the design process, it has to be that even the layman person is going to use it out, and you have to make the design in that way. And these are some of the real world examples. Your mobile, so when you take it as, let's say, it can be a miniature screen, or it can be a mini screen, or it can be macro screens. But the way how you are going to present up it has to be done there. So you have to know that how you are going to do it. It is not only with the computers, it is also with the VCRs, cars, your panels, all your dashboards, everything should be accessible. And what is the goal of HCI is nothing but how effectively, how efficiently, how enjoyably, and how safely you are going to do with your work. Next, how the usability is nothing but, it is not that you are going to go with a single task. It can be a high-end task also. You should have to go with high-performance task also. So whatever be the task is, how you are going to do it with a lower error rate. The usability is nothing but it should have a continuous throughput, and it should be accessible to be everyone. And you should, the user retention, you have to calculate how much time the user is retaining. For example, you have a Facebook, you are uploading a video, or you have a YouTube, you are uploading a video, means how accessible it is. Usually it will be calculated by number of likes, how presentable way if you are doing it. Even a small thing when you are doing in the presentable way, it goes with likes and this thing. So that will be the ultimate goal of your HCI. The next thing is how you are going to improve your interfaces. When you go with the interfaces, it's nothing but it depends upon the UI delegates. That is nothing but user interface design. So how you are going with this thing? You have standard softwares, everything to delegate this. Usually you call it as delegates. So delegates are nothing but the people who have to be respectable. So the same way, when you take it to the computer screen, when you are making something to be a presentable thing, it should be knowledgeable, it should be presentable, adorable, and also it should be admirable. So how you design the process is nothing but how you are going to design it, how you are going to use it, and how you are going to implement it. So when you are doing it, what happened? These are the steps usually for a design process. It is same as what you study in your SDLC cycle also. The only thing is what, here you are going with animated things, your interactive things. So when you are doing it, what happened means you have to have what are the, you should analyze for what you are going to do it out. What is your creative design? What are the alternatives you can do it with the design? How you are going to evaluate the thing? How you are going to implement it out? What are the alternatives you are going to use it out? How you are going to evaluate your options? What is the prototype you are going to implement? How you are going to test it and refine it? So here for everything what happens is you should know the cognitive skills. When you take it as cognitive, as a knowledgeable thing, and for a specific need you are going to do it. Usually when you are going with the interactive designs, when you are going with the human interact HCIs, you have to design it for a specific one. You should not broad, that is you have to go with the narrow end of the design, not with the broader aspect. So you have to implement what all things you are going to include it, what is the personality, what is the culture you are going to follow, how you are going to go with the skills, and what is the motivation. But you can come across two fatal errors. What are the errors you have it now? You cannot think that all the person is going to be the same desire, or all the person, whoever is going to view it is, will have the same opinions. As opinions can vary, and you cannot even make it with the same designers. So what are the, how you can evaluate it is nothing but what is the speed of performance, how you rate it without errors, what is the retention over time, and your user satisfaction. So with the usage with this thing, when you are doing it, it can be a group project or it can be an individual thing. Even if it's going to be a group one or anything, for example, you take an animated thing, how interactive it is, you are uploading into a thing. So you have the different steps to be followed. You should know for what you are going to do it, you have to understand it, for what problem you are going to do it. It can be a problem, or if it is going to be a storyboarding, you should know what is the story you are going to do it up, how you are going to explore it, and what is the prototype you are going to use it up. So you have some basics each thing. When you are taking with the design basics, you should know what is the process, what happens, when it's going to happen, who are there for the process, users, What is the scenario you are going to do it? Scenario is nothing but what is the story design you have, how we are going to navigate it, and how we are going to have the iteration and prototypes. So what is design is nothing but who is for and for what you are going to do it is a big design. We are achieving your goal within your constraint, you are taking it as design. You have some golden rules for design. So first thing is you should know, you should understand the material, you should understand the people, as well as you have to understand the computers. That is, you should have a proper dealing with your man, mission and your story thing. Now, when you take it as errors, human errors are common, it is normal, so you have to overcome that human errors also. Then, when you're dealing with the central, who is the central process, the end is nothing but the users, end users. So when you take it with the design process, you should find out what is wanted. You do the analyze, you do the design, you implement it and deploy it. And when you are doing the analyze and design, you can make it out the prototype. So here, it depends upon in what way you are going to do it. If in case you are going with the storyboarding, you are going with the animated movies or this thing, you have to find out what are the scenarios, what is the task analysis, what are the principles you are going to follow. And you have to go with each and everything with the precise thing. When you are taking the steps, it's again, I recommend analysis, design and iterations. And next, with the continuous iterations, you can develop it and implement it. And you have to find out the usability and you have to find out whether it is a good design or bad design. And you should know the users also, who are going to whom, who is the end user and who is the person who is going to use it out. And then, when you are taking the scenarios, for example, for a storyboarding, if you are going to do it, you have to decide it, to whom you are going to communicate and whatever you are going to communicate, it is being communicated properly without any deviations, whether your thinking has been indulged to your mind. So you should know, you should also understand the dynamics. When you are taking the scenarios, when you are going with the screen designs, it should go with the continuous walkthrough. That is what you can see. It can be a scene shot, it can be a movie thing, or it can be any short thing also. But your storyboarding should be there, that it has to make them thinking. And when you are using the design, it can be a throughput of design, you can even reuse the designs also. So everything you have to go with exploring to the depths. When you take it as depths, what are the things you should do with now? You have to explore the architecture, you have to explore to the depth your cooperative thinking as well as your interaction. So when you are able to do all the three things, it is that you are validating your model and you are expressing whatever you feel it and the dynamics you have it. So when you are taking the navigation design, it can be local design or it can be a global design. Anything can be. What is the main thing in this thing is nothing but your interaction, your widget should be there. The widget is nothing but what your UI delegate is going to speak it. So you should know what is the UI model I am going to use it, what is the application, for which application I am going to use it. So keeping on all these things, everything has been derived by the golden rules. And what is the four golden rules you have? It is where you are, what you can do with, where you are going and where you have been. So you have to know with the present, past and the future thing, and all the three should be done in the cyclic way. Now when you are taking with the screen design and layouts, it should be with the alignment, white space. That is, when you are taking the screen design, you should ask a question within yourself for what you are going to, who is going to use it out and what is the design you are going to follow with. As well as with the interaction control, the same thing should be there. And when whatever you are designing it, it is going to go with the culture and countries. So when you are going to the countries, you should go with the globalization. You should know whether it is going to go with the localization or globalization. Usually we have to adopt the globalization when you are going with your HCIs. And you should also go with your deeper issue is you have to carry out with the culture, what is the assumptions of the culture and what are the values you do it out. Now here I have given an example. The best example is nothing but you can take the movie of Piper, which is a 2017 Oscar winning film. In that film, what they have done is all the storyboarding, everything. That is, the main thing is nothing but they were in that film, they were able to give the thing of moral also. What is the moral they are giving? It is, they are giving a moral that you have even a person who is very fear will be able to, there is with experience and with this thing, he will be able to overcome that fear. Now, here in that film, they have narrated the story of a bird coming out from the nest. He is going on to get the first prey. But when he is going to get the first prey, he is coming on the waves, he is seeing it. Everything has been narrated in that way, that each picture wise, screen wise, shot wise, how they have narrated it. And it is a movie of 6 minutes only. But what happened, it is giving the moral impact as well as the impact to the thing, that everything has been visualized in that way. It has been visualized, delighted to the person. So automatically what happened, it took many times, the process, it has taken 3 years, but what happened, it has created a novelty that it was the best animation it has been made it up. And that can be taken to be as a best example for HCI. So when you're taking it, it's not only the program you make, how design you're making, it can be a web design, mobile design. Even with the movie player also, you can go with the web app. So thank you.